Most people in life are looking for how do I make a life worth living and return worth having. Well, we do that in a lot of ways. The truth is that anyone at any time can go out and get a different job. That is the premise of a lot of people's minds. I would like to differ slightly with that. It is absolutely true that I could try to walk in to a restaurant or a fast food place and borrow my skills from when I was 15 years old and do that job. The problem is, if I do that job on my resume, then I have totally obliterated the direction and trajectory of my life towards sophistication. You see, everyone is on a path, according to John Maxwell, a great author and spokesman and orator, is that we are on the path from survival to security to significance. When we are living with our parents in our childhood, we are in the survival mode because we only survive based on the gifts and kindness and love and peacemaking strategies we are taught within that home. As we move into our collegiate years and beyond them, we move into security, usually, of that we are responsible solely for our own lives. And therefore, we move away slowly and gently from our parents' income and revenue and resource support, and we move into our own professions and our own, well, income and taxes and everything that comes with that as an adult, in adulthood. If we're lucky and we move and maneuver ourselves socially and professionally in the right networks, not only in the jobs we choose to apply to, but the jobs we choose to take, and the organizations in which we choose to participate in, then we move ourselves towards significance. The concept of significance is that we are living not high on the hog, but we have enough for our living and a little left extra to put in our bank accounts for retirement. People who hit the lottery in terms of what they choose to do, they get involved with a small corporation, it goes global, it goes postal, whatever, you know, often make a huge salary and a huge impact on lives around them. I know one of the guys that owns one of the estates along, I think it's 216, I think it is, up in Noblesville in a community that I once lived in. He was some sort of a inventor of some sort of voicemail system, and that set him for life. That became the electronic or technological standard for everything. But I don't remember all the details. And he is a great supporter of the community, but he probably went on to do other things. You see, in our lifetime, we are highly not encouraged, but we must be encouraged to make multiple income streams. So while I might be able to go parlay my incredible abilities at a McDonald's or a Burger King, in terms of my customer service skills and my tolerance for working with young people, might go out the window, the reality is it's not going to pay for my living. It's not going to provide me any time to focus on getting the job in my industry, of which I've worked my whole life, but also it doesn't allow me to look at other industries in which I can use my skill sets and be employed to do something new, cutting edge, and different. You see, a lot of employers think, I'll hire a young person out of college who just got all this technical skills and will be good. I'll hire the young person who knows how to do all the social media because I can look at their channel and it looks good. The problem is they know nothing about your industry. The problem is they don't know what is and isn't correct to say. The problem is that they don't know the laws of your field. And the problem is that they're really not going to stand still today. You see, there is a formula for everything, but there's also a way to time ourselves out of our industries. And when we time ourselves out of our industry, we have to look back to God and the gifts and the skill sets and the talents that we have. And we have to have a partner in life, either in interpersonally, personally, intimately, or professionally, who said, hey, what I'm hearing from you is you're miserable in what you're doing. What I'm learning from you is that it's not going well. What I'm seeing for you is the writing on the wall, and I'm telling you, you better get the fuck out of there before you're fired. And that's all I can sell. But on top of that, what I'm going to do for you is help redirect you. I'm going to help introduce you. I'm going to help you find that next job. But I'm not going to force you to come work with me in my company because there's too many other people beyond me that could monkey our relationship. On the other hand, if I'm an independent business owner, I might say to you, look, there's a lot more potential working with me in partnership than there is in your industry because what you make for a month, I make in a week, or I make in a project. and with you beside me, I can make a lot more than that. That's how teams begin to develop. And family businesses are then passed on to children who may not have had a parent or a grandparent or a teacher or a professor or a pastor who helped them learn what their gifts are.